So, very good afternoon to all of you. Today, I'd like to concentrate on min-max problem. In the previous session, we had a talk on binary search, and it has been completed in the previous class. Today, we'd like to concentrate on the min-max problem, how minimum and maximum elements are supposed to be find by using divide and conquer method. We'd like to check or would like to concentrate on this particular problem. Before going to take this particular problem, we'd like to evaluate the Navy approach. I mean, using a general method, iterative method, how that could be without using any divide and conquer approach. How the Navy approach can be, how the things will be. Let us examine by taking a small problem or program in a courtship. Let me execute that. Courtship. Yeah, courtship IDE. So let us write a particular problem or program in C using CodeChef, and let us examine how the things are being happening here. So given list of elements will be, let me consider that is the list of elements might be LIST. So integer LIST of 100, these are the list of elements. Let me increase the size, then you could able to see this one very clearly. Okay, so probably the size will be visible to you, I think. The size will be visible to you in your phones or laptops or tabs. However, so then followed by, so for after getting minimum and maximum, let me store with min is one particular element, max is another element, and number of elements will be n, and I will be used to navigate that particular loop. Let me take one more extra element, that is frequency in the sense. How many number of comparisons will be happen? How many number of comparisons will be happen when the loop is being going on? So for that, I'd like to take frequency. Okay, however, so here, prompt messages are not supposed to be operated here. So therefore, I'd like to take into consideration that enter as a comment line, I'd like to write enter the number of elements to array, to the list or to the array. Of course, you can take at whatever the one. So scan it, percentage D, ampersand N. Yeah, N number of elements has been taken. Then followed by again, so enter, so N elements to the array or list, okay, array. So N elements must be, gets array added here. So then how that could be taken into consideration, let us have a look here for I will be equal to 0, I less than n, so I plus plus, then how this could be. So scanf for percentage D comma ampersand AI. Yes, elements have been taken. So in this way, input has been accepted in this way. Then followed by what we are supposed to do here is, before going to get the or achieve the minimum and maximum, what our assumptions could be. We don't know how many number of elements. Of course we know, but max and min could not know. So how many number of elements, so that so we'll consider first element will be, let us consider, for example, I'm talking about everything, for example. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, these are the elements which are available with us. So I'm trying to trace these elements right away from 1, 2, and so on. So initially, I'd like to consider this element will be both the minimum and maximum. The first element will be both the minimum and the maximum, so that we'd like to consider this particular element as minimum and maximum. Before that, we'd like to take some assignments. Minimum is equal to minimum is equal to m by n is equal to m a x is equal to a of 0. The first and foremost element will be considered as the minimum element, because we don't know how many number of elements, so that we'd like to perform this particular operation. Let us examine. And one more assumption we have to make here, for e, q, n, c, frequency will be equal to 0. So far, there is no comparison that has been happening here. No comparisons will be happened here. So that is the meaning here. Then followed by tracing of elements for, so let me copy this one. Let me copy this one from here. So it could be very easy to perform such kind of operation. So I will be, already f0 has been assigned to minimum and maximum. FB has been assigned to minimum and maximum, so that I'd like to start away from 1. Okay, then so if there is AFI element, AFI in the sense first element will be I will be equal to 1, then AFN is greater than the maximum. If it is really greater than the maximum, then what shall we have to do? Maximum element is being updated here. So let me update this element here. So maximum equal to AFI. Whatever the element which does have to be stored in here. Then this is the maximum identification which is being done. Then second comparison will be, so if f i will be smaller than minimum, then minimum equal to m I n equal to f I. So how many comparisons could be happened here? So this is the first comparison. So here it is the first comparison, and here it is the second comparison. Two comparisons are supposed to be done here. Okay. So therefore, frequency will be increased by 2. Frequency will be increased by 2, because two comparisons will be happen for every so I value. I equal to 1, 2 comparisons. I equal to 2, 2 comparisons, and so on and so forth. After completion of this one, yes, things are gets over. Max and min have taken into consideration. Things are gets over. Then what we are supposed to do? Print f. We'd like to print is the output. So max value equal to percentage d. So that max followed by the print f. Min value equal to, so min value equal to percentage d. Again, min. Then the number of comparisons. Last one is, so printf. So we would like to take the printf number of comparisons. Number of comparisons percentage d, that is frequency. We have taken as, so the element as frequency. So this is the specific problem. This is the specific problem. Let us enter the input. So input is, I am trying to take 10 elements. The first element will be 1, 5, 9, 6, 2, 3, 4, 8, and 7. These are the elements. These are the elements. The last and final element will be 10. Okay. So these are the specific number of elements. You can say this is 10 is the value of n. And these are the list of elements which are available with so-called n here. Now, let us run this particular problem. Yeah, just one or 2 seconds to be get the output. Yeah, you can see. Oh, I'm very sorry. Okay, let me change it, because always I have used the A only. So that let me take it as A. Yeah, everything is gets A only. Sorry for that. Yeah. It is being running. Where are the code? What is the code service you just made? Why? Unable to connect. Because of some power problems, internet has been gone away from me. So that now I would like to run this particular problem for you. Yes. Why? Let me copy this one and let me refresh this one again. Yeah. Tell me come. language is C, and I'd like to select and trace this one completely. And let me take the input here, that is the 10 elements. 1, 5, 9, 2, 6, 3, 4, 8, 10, and 7. Okay, these are the elements. These are the elements which I have with me. Then now I'd like to run this particular problem code when it could be executed properly or not. Let us check. Let us check for a while. Yeah, you can see. You can see number of elements will be 19. Number of elements will be 10. Then the max element is 10 and the minimum element is 1. Of course, everything is good. Then how many number of comparisons could be gets happened here? Just 18 operations. 18 operations, how you could write 18 operations here in the sense? Let me open MS Paint, then it could be very easy to explain to me. Explain to me, okay. Suddenly my system was struck. It's been come. MS Paint. Yeah. We'll be open MS Paint here. So here, value of n will be equal to, as far as our point of view, value of n will be equal to 10, and number of comparisons will be 18. How could you write this one here? So totally 2 into n will be equal to 20. So minus 2 will be equal to 18, right? So in this way, I'd like to frame this particular condition. I mean, complexity 2 into, so n minus 1. Will it be okay or not? Let me check it out. Okay, 2 into n minus 1. So will be okay or not? Let me check it out. Yes, it is okay. Because 2 into, so n will be 10 minus 1. That is equal to 2 into 9. Will be equal to 18. So this complexity will be gets okay. This complexity will be gets okay for Navy approach or general approach. So it has been taken 2 into, so n minus 1 as its time complexity, running time complexity. Worst case running time complexity will be this one. As far as the Navy approach is concerned, general approach is concerned. So is there any possibility to reduce this one or not? Yes, we have a possibility. So we have the possibility to reduce this particular thing. How this could be gets reduced here, let us examine. So 3 into n divided by 2 minus 2. This is the complexity where exactly we have to take in, or we have to implement same problem by using divide and conquer. How this could be done, let us examine. I hope that you do understand so far. So general problem is done, so that could be okay. And this is the complexity where exactly it could be taken in terms of divide and conquer, while implementing the same using divide and conquer. Let us examine. So I don't know why this meeting is, what happened? I hope that everybody is listening. Yeah, however, one moment please. Then I'd like to share my screen one more time. Yes. Since power cut is there here, so that is why we're facing such kind of problem today. Otherwise, there is no problem. Okay, look at this. The problem which we are going to study is min-max problem by using a divide and conquer. So what is the problem here? General problem here. So finding minimum, maximum, or maximum, minimum elements from the list of elements, how this could be done. So actual problem will be, n number of elements will be given to you. N will be an arbitrary number. Number of elements will be given to you. So within that particular number of elements, you have to identify what is the minimum and what is the maximum. Let us see, solve this particular problem by using divide and conquer method. It could be possible. So how this could be possible? Let us check it out. So as usual, we'd like to specify in divide and conquer method, so k number of recursive calls can be done. So therefore, so 2 power k will be equal to n. N will be always equal to 2 power k. So this equality must be there in our mind. So as soon as you have to discuss regarding to divide and conquer here. In the similar fashion, here also, your problem will be divided into k distinct subsets. Okay? Where k less than or equal to 1 less than or equal to k less than or equal to n. Then followed by, if the sub-problems are relatively large in the sense how many number of elements will be sufficient to perform this operation. Let me explain you. So if you consider either it is greater than or it is less than, either of these two operations will be gets operated out there in finding minimum or maximum. Greater than is the binary operator. It is a binary so operator. Either greater than or less than will be binary operators. So these binary operators must be required two operands. So is A greater than B or is A less than B? Something like this, two operands are required. So therefore, your problem, what is the small of P will be get satisfied here in the sense? Exactly, if you do have two elements in our sublist, then small of P will be get satisfied as far as minimum and the maximum is going to be done here. So relatively large in the sense, if number of elements within that particular sublist is greater than 2, then you will go ahead and divide them into many number of pieces. That how it could be done. So after dividing and solving, the problem will be get solved, then you have to apply combine all those solutions back. All those solutions in divide and conquer, in binary search, we did not see combine operation. Here, combine operation could be there. Combine operation could be there. So both sublists are supposed to be taken into consideration, and both sublists will be apply the divide and conquer, divide operation, and recursive call operation, and conquer operation. Combine operation also be done here. Let me show you how this could be. Okay. So these are the three steps which we have to follow. Then followed by what is the actual problem? Let us consider P will be our problem, having n number of elements, and these are the list of elements, A of I to A of J. For example, A of I will be equal to 1 or 0, and J will be equal to n or n minus 1. This is the problem here. And for this particular problem, of course, I have given what is n and what is this particular thing have given to you. And to solve this particular problem, following steps are supposed to be followed here. Number one, divide the problem P into several number of sub-problems based on its midpoint. Midpoint in the sense already we have taken as far as this particular list of elements, as far as this particular, let me change the color, then you could understand. As far as this particular list of elements, I will be first and this J will be low and high. So I, so plus J divided by 2, and which will be taken the floor of. This is the mid element which is being, of course, this has been, we have some experience to identify this one using binary search. Here also say. So based on the midpoint, you have to divide so that you could get two sub-problems. And this next stage also, you have to divide into some more sub-problems if your sub-problem does not contain 2. Okay? Divide will be get until a smallest sub-problem which will be contain exactly 2 elements. Okay? However, previous statement and this statement both are same. Both are same only. So this process will be continue until your sub-problem might have 2 exact elements. And followed by, then when we have to identify maxima and minima, then these subproblems will be determined to apply or compare so with each other and then identify the maximum and minimum. Okay. Then what shall we have to go to? So relative example or real-time example, however it might be. Let us consider these are the list of elements which are available with me: 10, 7, 20, 5, 6, 90, 5, 2, 3, and 8. These are the elements which are available with me. How this max and the minimum operation is going to be done here? So let us check. So here you can see low element is 1, low element is 1, plus high element is 9, that is log plus high divided by 2, that would be equal to 5. 10 divided by 2, that is equal to 5. So exactly at 5, 1 sublist, and at 6 to 9, another sublist. Yes, if you observe this particular sublist, this sublist has more than 2 elements. So again, divide operation could be gets operated here. It's also have more than 2 elements, so that we have to operate this one. Let us consider this particular subproblem. This subproblem will be P1, and this subproblem will be P2. Okay. Then, so apply the same divide operation at left hand side, so that left hand side in the sense, so here it is 1 plus 5 divided by 2. 1 plus 5 in the sink, 6. 6 divided by 2 will be equal to 3. So 1 to 3 will be one subproblem, and 4 and 5 will be another subproblem. Okay. And do the same operation at right hand side also. 6 plus 9, that is 17. 17 divided by 2, that will be equal to 8.5 actually. Sorry. 6 plus 9, 15. Sorry, it is 15. 15 divided by 2, that is actually 7.5 actually. So it is actually taken floor value. The floor value, so that it is 7. So from 6 and 7 is one sublist, and 8 and 9 will be another sublist. And here we'd like to consider this is problem P6, subproblem P3. So P4, P5, and P6. If you observe, P4 has satisfied the small of P conditions, that is exactly 2 elements. And the P5 is also satisfied, this is also satisfied. And the P6 also be satisfied, it does have exactly 2 elements. But P3 doesn't satisfy. And apply the same process here. So 1 plus 3, that is 4, 4 divided by 2, so that would be equal to 2. So 1 and 2 is first sublist, okay? And look at this, here we have only one particular element within the sublist. If such cases will be there, what exactly you are supposed to do here is, you have to duplicate the same number for twice. So like this. So same index value and the content of that particular index also be duplicated, because we are trying to identify maximum and minimum. Both will be required. So if you have a single element with you, you could not say that is either it is maximum or it is minimum. Two elements will be there, then we'll compare. So which is maximum and which is minimum, so that we have to duplicate it. Okay. Now you can see the problem P7, problem P8, P4, P4, P5, and P6. All these problems will be have 2 to 2 elements. So until this, so you have completed divide operation. Divide operation has completed. Okay, this operation was gets completed. Now, what exactly we are trying to do? So we are trying to do this particular operation here. Okay. So here we are going to operate our divide and conquer something like this. Min, maximum. So low will be the first element, the high will be. So this is the beginning of the sublist and it is ending of the sublist. So max. Sorry, several power cuts and several issues are there. So that is why I'm unable to continue. So here. So look at this. Instead of a maximum, min max or max min, however, whatever it may be, whatever the parameters it might be. So you can see. So when you are solving this particular problem, you must always keep the mind. So this is the first and foremost problem. You please remember this particular problem in your mind. First sublist will be P7 sublist will be, so 1 and 2 as its values, low and high. So 10 and 7 are the elements. So this particular snapshot must be there in our mind. Unless otherwise, you could not take. So for getting the particular snapshot, please wait a moment. Please wait a moment. So I'd like to copy this snapshot. This snapshot. I'd like to copy this one here, print the screen. So paste this one and let us copy. This must be there in our mind. Otherwise, you could not do anything here. Okay, you could not do anything here. Let me copy this one for a while and then solve this particular problem. Okay, let me take this one and paste somewhere else here. Not here. Here. So this one at this particular place. So it must be there. It must be there with us. Okay. It must be there with us. Somewhere else I'd like to paste here. Yeah, it is there with us. So look at this. Look at this. So here you please observe. You please observe. So here it is one. I hope that you may not be visible. So if it is laptop, it is okay, but now it could not be. So it is one and it is two. 10 and 7 are elements here. Okay, you can see here. You can see here. 1 is low and 2 is high and 10 is the maximum and 7 is the minimum. Okay, so here everything is gets identified. And solve the same in the P8 problem. This is actually P7 subproblem. Here it is. It has been solved. And then solve again a P8 subproblem. In P8 subproblem, so 3, 3. So elements, I mean indexes varies where the 3, 3. Yes, low is 3 and high also 3. 25 is the element in both sides. So 25 is minimum, 25 is maximum. After getting the solution, combine these two. Yes, these two will be gets combined. Then while combining, how many number of elements are there here? You can see low is 1 and high is 3. Total number of elements are 1, 2, 3. So here, what is the maximum element? That is 25. What is the minimum element? That is 7. Okay, so here 10 is one element, 7 is another element, and 25 is another element. Out of these, minimum is 7 and the maximum is 25. In this way, we have combined. Then again, you have to solve the same in terms of this particular P4 problem. So it is actually, solution has been done by so P3 here, and we'd like to solve the problem for P4 here right now. In P4, so look at this 4, 5 are so elements here. I mean index values are 690 will be elements here. So low is 4 and high is 5. 90 is maximum element and 6 is minimum element. Yes, it is, the solution has been done for this particular subproblem. And then you have to combine this. If you combine these, so 1, 2, 5. Now you can see how many index elements are there for P1. So 1, 2, 5. So therefore, you can see 1, 2, 5 are total. Low is 1 and high is 5. So now right away 25, 7. Look at this 25, 7 and 96. These are the elements. Out of these, 6 is minimum and 90 is maximum. 6 is minimum and 90 is maximum. Of course, left hand side has been done. So this problem is P1. P1 also so solved. Left hand side problem has been done. Now go ahead with right hand. So in right hand, 6 and 7, you can observe this one. So P5, this is actually P5. The problem is P5. 6 low and high is 7. And we have two elements, that is 5 and 2. 5 is maximum and 2 is minimum. So it's been solved. Again, 8, 9. So if you consider this particular thing, so 8 and 9 are low and high. So actually at 8th place 3 and at 9th place 8, out of these two, minimum is 3 and the maximum is 8. This problem also solved. This problem is P6, it's also solved. Then combine these two. If you combine these two, you could get 6 to 9. The indices elements are 6 to 9 here. Yeah, 6 to 9 will be taken. Low is 6 and high is 9. So you have elements 5, 2 and 8, 3. These are the elements which are available with you. So out of this 5, 2, 8, 3, 8 is the maximum most element and 2 is minimum most element. Again, combine these two. You could get a whole problem. Whole problem might be having 9 elements. 1 to 9. Low is 1 and high is 9. And then 90 is the, out of 90 and 6, these are the elements. And at right hand side, 8 and 2 are the elements. Out of this, minimum is 20. Sorry, this is 2 only, not 22. minimum is 20, topographical mistake. When I'm typing, this has been taken some mistake here. Minimum is 2, maximum is 90. Minimum is 2 and maximum is 90. So therefore, as a whole problem, the maximum element is 90 and the minimum element is 2. So this is the final output which we have got. Okay. To achieve this particular problem, so what is the actual algorithm we have to follow? So here three cases are there in the algorithm. If I equal to j, what do you mean by I equal to j? For example, I equal to 1 and j also equal to 1. For example, if you take, you have only one element will be there, you have 0 or you have 1, only one element, some 20 is there with you. If you have 20, could you identify which is maximum and which is minimum? No, it is. Because single element cannot be both the minimum and maximum. Okay, if you have two elements, then you could identify so which is minimum and which is maximum. Okay, so therefore, so it could be taken, this could be taken, t of one will be equal to 0. That is, if n equal to only 1, so what could be happen within single unit or 0 units of time, you'll define that as it could be. Then else if I equal to j minus 1. So I will be equal to some 1, j will be equal to some 2. That is, I is equal to j minus 1 in the sense 1 is equal to 1. That is the meaning. Yes, if this condition will be true, then what we are supposed to do? We are supposed to know. So two elements are there with you. So a of 0 will be there with you and a of 1 also will be there with you. Two elements are there. Then exactly you could get what is the minimum and what is the maximum. So look at this. If a of I is less than a of j, then maximum equal to a of j, minimum equal to a of I. Otherwise, so maximum equal to a of I, minimum equal to a of j. So to solve, if this particular, this is the case, from here to here, this is the case, how many number of iterations could be taken? Sorry, how many number of comparisons could be taken? One comparison will be taken. This is the comparison. Here, no comparison at all. Here, only one comparison will be took place. So therefore, if n will be equal to 2 number of elements, number of comparisons will be t of 2 will be equal to, so number of comparisons will be equal to 1. Okay. Otherwise in the sense, your number of elements not equal to 1, number of elements not equal to 2, more than 2, then what will be? You have to identify so mid element and pass the value something like this. So yeah, I to A of mid is 1 sublist, and so mid plus 1 to J is another sublist. So here you could identify in the first recursive call, these two are max min. In second recursive call, so max 1 and min 1. And you have to compare these two. Look at this. If maximum is less than max 1, then max equal to max minus max 1. Because if maximum 1 is a bigger value than whatever the max 1 in first call, then max 1 will be the final value. So if min is greater than min 1, so min 1 is very smaller value, then min 1 is the answer. Okay, in this way. So to solve this particular problem, look at this. We have taken so n by 2, and it has been taken n by 2. Again, n by 2 here. And here, one comparison, number of comparisons here we have made. So n by 2, number of comparisons. Here also, we made n by 2, number of, I'm talking about comparisons. These two are comparisons. So comparisons, these two are divisions. I'm talking about this. These two are the divisions, okay? In this way, we have developed. And I'll give you this particular problem. I'll forward this particular problem through Google Classrooms. Okay. Now, so complexity analysis is not supposed to be done because we have only 3 minutes in our hand. So it could not be done at this moment. If you have any questions, please forward your questions through Google Classroom. Then I will answer them on MinMax also. On MinMax also, I will answer them clearly. So in Google Classrooms, please forward some questions to me. then I'll answer without having any hesitation. Okay. So complexity will be taken by tomorrow. So we'd like to go through a quick review. Quick review could be taken here. So you can see these are not this one here actually. It's also here. Okay, N elements will be there with you. Then divide and conquer technique can be used to solve. Then followed by K distance sub problems will be taken because this is the basic primitive of so divide and conquer. Then here it is when relatively large, then you have to divide into smallest problem. Smallest problem would be how could you specify the smallest small of people we get satisfied here is. So number of elements will be 2. Then the things will be gets combined back. Here we have applied the combining. Everything will be gets operated here. And if you have any question, so please go through this video one more time. Then so this understanding of this particular two slides are very, very important. Understanding of this real-time example is very, very important. This is pretty much important. Okay, this is very, very important. Understanding of this one is pretty much important. Please remember this. Okay, then so the min max algorithm can be seen in such a way, low, high, max and minimum. Why this max and minimum also parameters here? What is the reason behind this here in the sense? So any call by value function, you consider whatever the call by value function, that call by value function cannot return more than one value. So that is why these two also parameters here. Call by value function, not only in C, anywhere else, you could go ahead with any kind of programming language, it could not be call by value, cannot be written more than one value. So because of that reason, max and min has taken so this one. So understanding of this one also very, very important. Please go through this particular video one more time. Then you could understand very clearly. So just wait for a while. I'd like to take the attendance at this moment. Please wait for a while. Don't go away.